Friend of mine was telling me, a lady came back, parked her car just from here to Michigate. She came back again to go and just quickly check out something. She had an accident. She had run around town. She had done what she needed to do. Just park her car. Let me just go and pick this man to Michigate and take the lady for a quick move. The lady had an accident. She fell out of the car, put her head on the slab, died instantly. No room for hospital. So we don't serve God either. Just wonder. If COVID-19 don't make you to serve God, I don't know what will ever make anyone to serve God. Alright. Grace to walk in the supernatural. Thank God for walking in the supernatural. It is so revealing. God has helped us and is helping us. Amen.
Amen.
This morning you will be my friend if you respond, amen.
Yeah.
There's no other way you collect what is said in the supernatural way and in the spiritual realm than your response of healing.
Amen.
There's no other way you collect it. You're closing your mouth is a direct way of saying, I am not part of it. It's not something you say in your heart, it's something you speak out. Amen.
Amen.
Today, I've been looking at the mysteries. And that's what we've been looking at. But today, we talk about grace to walk in the supernatural. We all know that this kingdom is run by mysteries. And that's why some people can be in the church. Instead of getting blessed, they get cursed. Make no mistake, thinking that it's all that come to church that get blessed. Make no mistake about it. Those that lack understanding, that dear God, they go with curses that may take generations before it can be wiped off. That's the danger. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
It is still the same God of the Old Testament that is the God of the New Testament. The difference is that Jesus did something for us. And when Paul looked at what Jesus did and saw how some people are taking it for granted, he began to lament and say, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? He said, God forbid, how dead is it that we that were dead to sin now live in it? So let me quickly say that grace is not minus living a life of righteousness. Rather, grace points us to Christ. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So in the kingdom that we found ourselves is run by mysteries. The kingdom of God and the highway being flourished with mysteries. And the lead way to walking in the supernatural is mysteries itself. It's not normal. So you can't reason it with a normal hearing. With a normal reasoning. If you want the supernatural breakthrough, you must understand the mysteries that are involved in walking in the supernatural. You can't think it with your mind. It is not normal with your mind. Praise God. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6 to 7 will help us. Brother, we'll take it up to verse 9. I read, howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect. Yet not the wisdom of this world. Did you understand that?
Yes,
the wisdom we talk about is not wisdom of the world. Because let me give you a reason. There's no wisdom in the, if you slap me, I say God bless you. Is there any wisdom in it? As far as this kingdom is concerned, is there any wisdom? The kingdom of the world, there's no wisdom. The person will keep intimidating me. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So it is tooth for tooth. says in this kingdom, is it when Jesus said, if they slap you like this, men wait this other way. Amen. In this kingdom, Jesus said to us, he that will be the head, first let him be the servant of all. So the highway to leadership, to honor, is servanthood. If you don't have a servanthood attitude, God will not promote you. You may promote yourself. It means you can't give yourself that. I always say to you here, if you open the door for yourself, you won't go too far. Because you need to be by the door to hold the door. But when God opened the door for you, he will make you go far because he's minding the door for you. Because when he opened the door, no man can do what? And when you open it, there are men that can shut it for you. All right, let's move ahead. He said, none of the prince of this world that come to naught. So the wisdom of this world comes to what? But we speak the wisdom of God in what? In mystery. Even hidden wisdom. So this wisdom is not made available to all men. It is hidden. This wisdom is hidden. So it is in your searching for it that it becomes available for you. This wisdom is not all common thing. So you must show some level of diligence. It's the which God ordained before the world unto our glory. Verse 8, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified what?
The God of glory.
So there is a wisdom in Jesus going through the cross. Did this just help me?
Yes, sir.
So when you go through the cross to where God is taking you to, you need to understand something. It is still all foolishness. There's still wisdom in it. So there is wisdom of God in God taking him through the cross. So you can understand with me today, there are certain times we are going through some things that are so palatable. It's not so palatable to us. That are full of problems. It is not all against you. Let me say this quickly. It is not what we've been through that makes the difference. It is how you go through it. Can I say it again? It is not what we've been through that makes the difference. It is how you go through it. Because most of the things you are going through, someone has gone through it. The difference of your resolve is how you navigate through what you are going through. There's no one here who will say is the author of delay. People have gone through delays in life. But some went through delay and their delay brought something to them. Some went through delay and their delay bring them to damnation. It's a mystery. How can you explain it? That God intentionally closed a woman's womb and flourished another. And the one who closed his womb is the one he's interested in. So how can you explain it that there's somebody who is going through delay in life is the one God is supporting? Is the one God wants to take something from? Could I explain it to you in Abraham? How many of his brothers were having children? But when it came to Abraham, it was a special child God was looking for. Can I explain it to you in Hannah Pelina? How is that Pelina? Anytime he comes to the husband, nothing happens. But Pelina, listen, visit the husband. How can I explain it? Now, when you understand some of these things, certain things that are going on in your life, you will be able to manage it if you don't allow the word you hear in church to leave you after church. But then, as it is written, I have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have we entered into the heart of what? The things. How many things?
Yes.
Which God had prepared. Which God had done what?
Prepared.
For who?
Okay.
For them who will love him even in the situation they are in. God. It will be prepared. It has been prepared from the word go.
Praise the Lord.
So when you understand the mystery and engage it as a lifestyle, engage these things as a lifestyle, you command supernatural breakthrough. Certain things begin to happen around you, and people think there's something different about you. It is the mystery that you have decoded and you are practicing in your life. And that one Bible says, it is not he that heareth the word that is blessed. I want your attention this way, please. It is not he that heareth the word that is blessed. It is he that applies the word. It is the doer of the word. When you begin to engage the word you heard in your daily lifestyle, diligently and carefully. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When you come to this, let me quickly say that nothing makes a man great like grace. Nothing makes a man great like grace. Labor, hard work does not make a man great. Laka brada santale brada obuska. What is grace? Grace is one of the most vital mysteries that provoke God for supernatural breakthrough. Grace. When you see a man carrying grace, what he will do will look easy, but go and do it. He does not travel. He does what?
Rebel.
Thank you, church. He does not do what?
Travel.
What does he do?
Rebel.
He prevails. Because the battle is not his. He's engaging on the battle that been fought. Until you come to understand in this world that all battles are not yours. Amen.
Amen.
I stumbled through something someone posted. I don't take credit to it. The person said, is it one thing I've learned that made me great is that I stop fighting battles that I shouldn't fight. He said, one, I don't fight battles about what people think about me. He said, they are minor battles. He said, I don't fight with my spouse. He said, they are minor battles. I don't fight what people say to someone about me. He said, they are minor battles. He said, I don't fight about what idiots think about me. He said, they are minor battles. Can't drop shame. He said, I don't battle what foolish people say, because they will say certain things and you're like, man. So when you hear people say things that doesn't add up, mature, it is in the category of fools. So there's no response that will convince a fool.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You see, but I fight the battles of my vision. Say, I fight the battles of my vision. What will make me be better than I am? That's where I put all my strength. I don't put my strength in saying, you say, you talk, say, you not talk, say, you not talk, say, you not talk, say, you waste your strength. A man that walks in grace does not have time for such. Did you hear what I just said? So today, know is that your breakthrough does not lie in your strength. It does not lie in your strength. 1 Samuel. Let me show you something. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 1. But limited from verse 1 down is the prayer of Hannah is very interesting. I don't know how far I can go with it, but let me just try how much I can go down and this one from verse 9 quickly. And Hannah prayed and said, my heart rejoices in the Lord, my horn is exalted in the Lord, my mouth is enlarged over my enemies, because I rejoice in thy salvation. There is none holy as the Lord, for there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God. He said, talk no more so exceedingly proudly, let not arrogance come out of thy mouth, for the Lord is a good, a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed. In my Bible, they say that God is a God of knowledge, and by him I underline it. Now look at what struck me when I read that in my Bible. He said, he knows the things they say. He understands the validity of what they say. He knows the weight of what they say. He knows how it affects me. So all that I think people say, I shouldn't bother myself if I know that he knows what. Take me back there now. No, 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 not back for that, really. You see, by him, actions are way. So he goes past what you say. Verse 4. And the Bible says, he said, the bows of the mighty men are broken. See, the bows of the mighty men cannot give them the desired result. Did you get that?
Yes,
please follow me quickly. And they that stumble are gifted with strength. Yes, they did what? They stumble. They have strength. They said, created with strength. But they stop. But they that stumble are not done without strength.
Yes,
that's what the Bible is saying. Did you get that?
Yes,
so it is not they that has strength. And now in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 11, time we fail to go back there. He said, I return and I see under the earth, it is not him that willeth, nor him that runneth. Are you here? Say, but the strength is not for what? Alright. Take me verse 5. They that were full hired out themselves. For bread. Go to the street, you see them. Mighty boys. They work for nothing. Their hungry seized, so that the barren had born seven. The one that is least expected, the one that walks in grace, had seven. And she that had many children is wax feeble. Upon the children they had, there's nothing those children can do to them. When you have children, they sustain you in a time of weakness. But this one that have many, he has many, but yet he was feeble. The one who had one become better. There are people you see in the streets, they have children, but they are better than those who doesn't even have a better than them. They're not talking as if they are. The Lord killeth and the Lord maketh alive. He bringeth down to the grave. He said, the Lord maketh poor and maketh rich. He bringeth low and lifteth up. He raiseth up the poor out of the dust and lift up the beggar from the dunghill, and to set them among what? And make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he has set the world upon them. Please mark, the pillars of the earth are the Lord's. Please look this way. He sets them. The pillars of the earth are the Lord's. He did what?
Yes.
Who owns the pillars of the earth?
The Lord.
So it's not your struggle. It is he that raised men who were nobodies. He will take by himself, bring them among princes. Go and check the history of men who got raised. They are men of no good beginning. Some of them are cast out. Some of them are even those that were born out of wedlock, that have no place of acceptance. You didn't hear what I said? So God decided to raise them so that those who would have believed them would have died. There are people that live in your village. The reason why they are still prominent is because they are so rich that nobody can tell them who is your father. Come on now, you're not talking to me now. So God give them some level of raising so that you can close your mouth. Take them. Because if you leave them, some of you will tell them how their father was. And all kinds of things and all that. So when you look at them, they are so, and they are most of them, they are so generous. They are the one lifting others. God decided to say, this one, if I leave them to lift you, they will not lift you. Let me go lift you by myself so that you can help me to lift others around you. And you will make a nation by yourself around you. So God does that all by himself. Does nature not even speak to us? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If I were you, I would just wave my hand and give him thanks. Then what is grace? Grace for me is the tangibility of God's hand in the life of a man. Is the visibility of the hand of God in the life of a man. That's grace. You see, you can dress to the accepted. If there's no grace in the life, there's no grace. Praise God. Oh, yeah, let me leave you this morning. You're not in the mood of saying hallelujah this morning. Did you hear what I just said? Grace will make you go into a place and people will accept you without struggle. Just accept you. It's not that you dress better than the other person. No, I like dressing. Dressing is good. Huh? But a man that has the hand of God in his mouth. So in all your daily prayer, one prayer you pray, Lord, let your hand rest upon me. That was what who prayed. Jabez, he didn't ask for much. It's a grace. He said, Lord, that your hand may rest upon me. What he was asking is, the Lord, let grace punish me. Grace. It is the tangibility of God's hand. Undeniable of God's hand. There are certain things you will see around someone, you know the man, this one I got. This man. One pastor looked at his vision. Don't forget all those things. I grace, thank you. I said, thank you. I'm away. Because time has proven it over and over again. That was what make Sam. The psalmist said, here do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear. It's because grace is with him. For thou art with me. It is not God by personality. It is the grace of God. The grace of God. Receive that grace in the name of Jesus. Receive that grace in your life. Receive it in your job.
Amen.
Receive it in your business.
Amen.
Receive it in all that you do.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you believe, let me hear your amen like you really mean it.
Amen.
Let me show you something in Titus. Titus 2 verse 11. It says, for grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to how many men?
All men.
This one got power. It's not selective. it appeared to all men. So you see, the level of grace that you receive, so to ask whether you have grace, it is how the grace is lighted up. You can never achieve beyond the grace that is available in your life. And it's a grace that lights you up. But let me quickly say that grace can be frustrated. God can give you grace, but you frustrate the grace. Do you know what I said? Yes. Then you frustrate it. But look at that if you have time. Did the grace appear to you? Or did he answer?
Yes, sir.
Did you wake up in the right place this morning?
Yes, sir.
Did the grace appear to you?
Yes, sir.
Some of you may say, I understand. Say, Papa, how can grace appear to me? I'm like this. You can't see it, and that's why it's not working. The Bible has said it, that grace appeared to all men. Then what does he want? It's not that way they're sharing something. And you say, nobody like me, and you say like this. And somebody went there, they are not giving me stand up and say, please, I'm here. And when he take it, he has taken it, isn't it? And then you go home complaining, he go home, does what? Rejoicing because he took a step of faith. The grace to stand up and say, I'm here, was available. The you that was counting who robbed you and who didn't rob you, you miss it. Now I'm saying this to say, don't get angry easily. Mostly when destiny issues are being discussed, the devil will make you get angry. And when you miss it, you have missed it. Is somebody getting something here?
Yes,
if you consider what people say, what people do, you may miss your portion. Sometimes you just need to overlook people and do what God asks you to do. It may not make sense when you're doing it. They may say, but at the end of the day, if it's the Lord that led you, you will have the best life.
Yes.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes,
so you don't really need to worry yourself. And, okay, well, look at what Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 5, from chapter 15, verse 10. So when we read the title screens, that is practically the grace of God reflects in the life of every believer. Did you hear that now?
Yes,
sir. All right. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 10. He said, I am. Paraphrase it, that I am who I am. By grace. He said, for I deliver unto you. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 10. For by the grace of God, I am what?
I am.
What I am. And his grace which was bestowed, which was given to one man, he said, was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. Meaning to some people, this grace ends up what? Oh, but I labor more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but what? So even the things you do to get what you want, the labor, the move, the steps you take, is not you. It is still the grace. But the grace of God which was with me. So grace is not a support to laziness or arrogance. He said the grace was bestowed, yet I live more than everyone. Not I, but the grace. Naturally speaking, people like us, I don't know what will happen. Walk through the day, be be up from 12 till you come to church and stand and preach 12, 4 services and still ready to preach more. It is grace. It will labor that this grace manifests. If you don't engage it, you don't even know that the grace is available. Did you hear what I said? Or if you sit and say, Lord, I need your grace, are you sitting? If you say, Lord, I need your grace, he said, the grace I've been giving to you, stand up and activate it. Take a step. Amen. There are some characteristics of grace we want to look at quickly. I think in Genesis chapter 12, verse 2, God said to Abraham, I will make you. I will make you. But Abraham was not indolent. He was still walking. He was still believing. But God said, I will make you. Amen?
Yeah.
God. If you want to be great, you need grace to be great. The characteristics, number one, living the virtue of this characteristics of grace. You must understand, number one, grace can be frustrated. Grace can be what? Galatians chapter 2, verse 21. Okay. The grace of God, for if righteousness come by the law, then what? I thought you're there. You're not there. So a man can cripple the grace, a man can frustrate the grace. Show you people, let's look at you. Hebrews 12, verse 15. Some of the characteristics of grace. Number one, grace can be frustrated. Number two, grace can fail. Hebrews 12, 15. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God. Did you see that?
Yes, sir.
Carefully watch. Lest any man fail of grace. Why would that happen? Lest any root of what? Spring up, trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. Bitterness will make you lose grace. It reduces the grace of God that is at work in you. Bitterness. Bitterness is not about bitter people. They don't even agree that they're bitter. They say, no, it's all right. They make excuses and speak up to you around it. If there are people you wish evil, you're bitter. You go at their back and wish them that they don't succeed, you're bitter. Because if God, if other men deal with you, by the way, it is the grace of God that somebody forgave you, isn't it? And that will give you a chance for something. Yes. Hey. So you see why many of us are not operating the supernatural. No matter how much the, your heart condition, bitterness. He says the root. Now it means nothing grows when the root is not doing well, isn't it?
Yes,
so when the root of the man is having issues, then there's a problem. Number three. Number one, in case you forgot, grace can be frustrated. Number two, grace can fail. Number three, grace can grow. 2 Peter 3, 18. What is making this noise? I've kept quiet and nobody's observing. Change the microphones around you, please. Second Peter 3:18. He said, then grow in grace. And in what?
Knowledge.
What does knowledge do? What does knowledge do? Knowledge will define your lifestyle. Knowledge will define your action. Huh?
Yes, sir.
For my people perish for lack of what?
Knowledge.
So the knowledge they don't have is the knowledge that would have helped them to do the right thing, that would have made them do well. When you live in fear, it's because you lack the knowledge, the respect knowledge to overcome fear, isn't it?
Yes.
Is it the knowledge of our Lord? You need to know Him and Savior Jesus Christ. You have to have this knowledge of Him, that it is not you that dictates the way, it is Him that dictates the way. To Him be the glory, both now and when? So grace can grow. Grace can grow. Grace can grow. Amen.
Amen.
So grace, the level of the grace, your grace, the way your grace grows, the way your greatness grows. Did you hear what I said? It is the more of the grace that you have, the more of what? Your greatness. The less of the grace, the less of your growth. I pray that someone grace will grow this morning.
Amen.
And the knowledge. Amen.
Amen.
So grace is what defines your greatness. What defines our greatness?
Grace.
Grace. So grace can grow. That means greatness also can increase. From glory to glory. From grace to grace. From greatness to greatness. There are levels of greatness. When you meet great people, they see other great people, they say, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I was with a very big man. And he was talking to somebody, say, sir, sir. In my mind, I said, what is man? They call the answer, sir. I said, I want for life for Flemus Day. That's what he said to me. You did not share the answer, sir. When you come up, another man answer you, sir. Another man say, answer you, sir. Another person answer. It is grace by grace by grace. So it is a life thing. You just keep growing. Don't jump it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, I'm growing.
I'm growing.
It's important for us to know that jealousy ground grows in grace. Jealousy will make your grace not to grow. When you appreciate what God has done for another person, you are the next candidate. Those that know me know that if my friends buy a car, I fell. I said, that's a countless time. I will buy fuel for them and stand by the door and enter. I said, man, give me brother. I will go this and I said, thank God for you, brother. All with my heart. They are fired out by the grace of God. When my own come, it's always better than what my friends had. This one, when we say I'm a Christian, there are some Christians that are wicked. We even see somebody dressed, they say, I beg you, go. And wear dress. If they give you a dress, you're like, oh. You wear shoes, they say, I beg you, know how you get down. You follow her. As long as you don't give up, mind your business. Oh, you dance, you see, I see the dance. I said, no, me, I'm dead. Do you know what God did for you?
Hey, hey, hey.
Jealousy.
Hey.
Jealousy.
Hey.
Not appreciating what God has done for other people. My time will fail me to continue. Probably in the next service, I will look at some anti-grace, what I call the viruses of grace. It's a virus. I feel like the last days I should teach you these things. Hosanna.
If you will say something you did,